ever creepy UNG Maki.
Yeah. Very. Seems to be colder in here, you know that?
I thought that as well. The second this man stepped through the curtain, the temperature dropped in here.
Well, anyway, episode 36 of this SWE Uprising web show is rocking and rolling. Here we are in the Urban Complex, John Young, Jimmy Young here at ringside. We have the commencement of the Future Division Championship Tournament taking place later on in the hour as the Dark Player takes on, or is scheduled to take on, the returning LGT, which should be an absolute cracker. But first up we have
Shoot Maki.
He's quite a character, John.
Yes, you're not kidding. He certainly is. Maki is scheduled to take on a relative unknown here in the SWE, an outsider by the name of King Chris Lamb from UPW up north in Peterhead. Hope that entrance gear's clean. Rippy didn't have his eye on that one, did he? You know, I've seen a real change in Maki recently. Feels overlooked and rather bitter about him. They seem to be cheering up a bit these days. Still carrying that spade though, that vaunted spade. Maki has the microphone.
It's on.
They don't like it when you do that to the microphones. I'll get into trouble. I'm going to be honest. I have come out here numerous times over the last year and I have complained. I have shouted at you people. And I'm going to be honest, I feel really bad. I have been mean. I have been horrible. And I kind of feel like no one likes me.
You're all right.
I have behaved terribly though. Hold on to this. I've hit people with a spade. It's a spade, not a shovel. It is. You know, but that's fine. I just wanted people to like me. And when that didn't work, I got upset. But I did have a tantrum, right? I just wanted to be the rainbow in someone else's cloud.
Aww.
But I have been up to something, a brilliant endeavour, an endeavour to help the disadvantaged, the unfortunate, the rejected. Ladies and gentlemen, my change of heart has led me to put together Mr. UNG Maki's School for Rejected Luchadors. And tonight, here, I want to introduce you to my star pupil. He's my only pupil, but he's a pupil nonetheless. Ladies and gentlemen, please give an explosive welcome to that big bang effect, Atomico!
Look at this! Who is this little guy? I love this wee guy!
atomical. Look at this.
Wow.
I think Spike Tierney's got some competition on his hands here.
Like a McDonald's, eh? But sure, that's motivation enough for the wee man.
And his opponent, from United Pro Wrestling, here is
well, I'll tell you what here. This guy, like I say, a relative not known here in the SWE, could be a real dark horse in this match. I can say I come backstage before the show and he just sneered at me.
Chris Lamb!
Oh, this guy looks like a bottle of wax.
Yeah, I like this guy.
Chris Lamb, a self-professed king, comes to us tonight from United Pro Wrestling, which is based in Mintlaw, just outside Peterhead. You know, yep. Peterhead quite well.
Yeah, yeah.
We've made many a quick stop to the Queen's Hotel up there, not the Queen's Hotel, the Palace Hotel. Thinking about the Queen's Hotel, we're in there on the 29th of December. Yes, you and I, Bo, have had many a fun night in the Palace Hotel, Peterhead. Well, that's nice. Thanks for coming, man. Well, Chris Lamb certainly not endearing himself to the natives here in Dundee.
I'll be honest with you, I really don't know what to call here.
Well, I've never seen this guy, Chris Lamb, before, but he looks like a complete athlete.
Mackie giving some last minute instructions to young Atomical here. Chris Lamb going for the Pearl Harbor job to begin with. Mackie having none of it.
Well, I'll say this, I hope this guy's not looking for a serious wrestling
match. Oh, look at this.
You and Mackie. Look at the strength of this guy, though.
But Mackie's got the tenacity.
Oh!
He's a clever, clever wrestler. Despite his stature.
He's one of the most clever men I've ever met.
Yes, well, Mackie might be short on stature, but he's long on guts and determination, that's for sure.
Big in heart.
You
can actually think Atomico's bigger than Mackie.
Well, I wouldn't go quite that far, but they're not far off each other, that's for sure.
I mean, Matty actually looks up to Atomico. Oh, wow!
The chase is on.
Oh! Oh!
Ian Lamb out on the floor in front of us here.
Marking out, sizing up Lamb.
Lariat by Mackie, going in for the cover. That leg, referee. Oh, only a two count. Mackie now, going for a springboard. Caught in midair by Chris Lamb.
Wow!
Absolutely beautiful vertical suplex. The second over the outside, all the way to the middle of the ring, and it. Oh, no, only a two count.
Shut up!
Make sure that arm, though. Make sure that forearm's not under the throat, under the jawline. Oh! Stiff knife edge shot. Mackie's chest already turning red. This guy, Chris Lamb, certainly exhibiting a strength advantage over Mackie.
Very impressive.
Beautiful seed sent on. Only, I think Mr. Mackie's best chance of winning here is making sure that the best offense is a good defense.
Come on!
Oh! High impact on that one. Pal, you're never going to beat Mackie with a cover like
that.
Watch
it, little man. You watch it. This is how it's done. Back
down. Oh. Up now. Hard slam. Right in the centre of the ring.
This guy is good. I like this guy. Whoa.
Beautiful. High elevation elbow drop. Only gets a two count though. I tell you, I hope this guy's not taking Mackie lightly.
I think he knows now.
Onto the knees of Chris Lamb. Well, the crowd are certainly behind you and Mackie here at the Adler Complex.
That difference made the last thing.
I'm the best!
I think they've actually forgiven him.
Oh, this guy's... Tilt the world side slam. In for the cover. Only a two count. Lam now trying to Irish whip.
No! No!
Mackie, but Mackie's got his arm and his leg.
Yeah.
Down the ropes. Oh! Oh! Well, that's the fast track to a cauliflower ear, that's for sure. Oh! Beautiful cross body. Mackie for the cover.
This guy, Chris Lam, still got a few. Still got a half a tank full. He'll still do it.
Now. Oh, beautiful bulldog! He suckered Lam into that one. Only a two count. Almost a code breaker there by Chris Lam.
Atomico's.
Oh, look at this now. Oh, come on. Mr. Big Shot.
Well, he's going to learn a harsh lesson here.
Devastating impact. For the cover, hooks the leg. Oh!
Good count.
I thought for sure he had him that time.
Come on! Yeah. Yeah. Let's finish this one!
Yeah. Mackie now going for that sliced bread.
Yeah. Mackie was going for that sliced bread. Like, ends up getting tangled in the referee.
Yeah.
Not that either will complain about that. Oh, look at this! Atomico! Oh! Sliced bread! Or you could call that the half loaf!
Wow!
Great to see there's no intimidation in the wee man. Mackie now. Climbing the ropes, up the top. Oh! Beautiful guillotine leg drop by Mackie! In for the cover now! Two! They got him!
Well, the first venture out for Mr. Yoonji Mackie's School of Rejected Luchadors is a successful one here this week on the web show. What's Mackie motioning for? Oh, he's wanting. Ah, he's wanting Atomico's music playing. Unreal athleticism and agility for such a wee guy. Well, do you know what? It's good to see Mackie with a smile on his face again. But folks, don't go away. Uprising, we'll be right back.
Hey, this is one half of the greatest tag team of all time. From the Legion of Doom, Road Warrior Animal. That's right, it's me. And I just don't wrestle for anybody when I go to the great country of Scotland. No, I don't. I wrestle for SWE, David Lowe's company. That's right, I said SWE. You gotta remember, in Dundee, it is SWE country. SWE accepts no imitations, and neither does the Legion of Doom. Oh, what a rush. SWE.
Next week, right here on the SWE Web Show, we will see the continuation of the Future Division Championship Tournament's one half of the betrayal. Luke Aldridge takes on Jace Jackson. Also, in tag team action, Dead Cell, the hardcore champion Kevin Williams and his partner Nathan Reynolds take on Fortune 500. Also, the hashtag scumbag Ian Ambrose in action. All right here next week on the Web Show.
Oh, there's my friend, I love darling. He is one frustrated man.
Look up over there, look at those championship belts.
Deserves it. Coach never had a shout at anything. He's taking his pick. Which one shall I go for, he says. Gave Darren a bit of smoke there because I like him. Oh, Darren, you're the man. You're the man. You're the man. Get that belt. You need the belt.
Well, that was classy.
When you're LGT, don't you? I'm going to be there. I'll be there on the 24th November. Where are you? I know. I know exactly where he is. He's at home cradling his son. With a couple of black eyes. Like, Susie, you couldn't afford me, all right? LGT isn't here at all. It's not very fun or fair when you get betrayed like that, isn't it? It's a wee shame. Blair, you've been here for a long time, all right? You've been here for a long time. Take the mask off. You don't need it. He's not here. LGT isn't here. So therefore, I think that's my opportunity. That's my opportunity. I'm into the second round of the Future Division tournament. Is that a bit?
You see, normally you could have been. But what you've done is you've just pissed off the GM.
Oh dear, we can't do that.
We seem to cross this bridge every so often. So instead, we're going to do something a little different. Ladies and gentlemen, this match will now be an 8-man tag team match.
Wow!
And Darren Blair, Darren Blair, I'd advise you to get your ass back in the ring, because right now you're going to meet the rest of your tag team partners. The first member, here is KJ Nitro.
Oh, he looks like he means business.
And the third member of the team.
No way.
What's this?
John
Kerr.
Darren Blair, the fourth member of the team.
Oh, it's the best looking man!
It's Susie's little boy, Mighty Fine, Eddie Devine.
I love Eddie Devine, yes! Come on, me Eddie! Come on, Eddie, yes! Eddie! Come on, Eddie! Come on, Eddie! That guy is in great physical shape, look at that!
And I've assembled a nice little team just now to take you on. Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on this team! Introducing first, here is the man of Guam, Zach Leon!
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose.
And his tag team partner, here is Johnny Thunder!
A number.
Well, I'll tell you what, this was very unexpected. 8-man tag team match.
That's right.
And their tag team partner, please welcome Spike Tierney. Team, here he is, Ken Hayden.
What a formidable team this is. Ken Hayden, Zach Leon, Johnny Thunder, Spike Tierney.
What with that first team though? last 4 minutes. Look at KJ Nitro. He is so focused. Look up. Anger on his face. Nitro looks totally fired up.
KJ Nitro is an incredibly intense man, to say the very least.
He's looking in great shape. But I think the wild card here is Eddie Devine. Eddie is in fantastic condition.
Like it's going to be Zach Leon and Darren Blair starting things out here.
To me, John, I think Darren's got something to prove here.
He's got a massive chip on his shoulder.
But is it any wonder? The guy's never had a push. Deserves it.
Darren Blair, who has been hampered with knee injuries in his life, his looks are very deceiving. He's a very young man. He's only 22 or 23 years old.
Who is?
Darren Blair.
Really? I thought he was younger than that.
But he's had his, well, more than his fair share of injuries in his career.
Because he puts himself on the line.
That could be very true.
Come on, Eddie. You come, son. Eddie Devine's been tagged in.
Eddie, who could do with some wrestling gear.
Go on, Eddie. Come on, Eddie. Oh. Well done, Eddie.
Keenan now scooped up. Hard slam. I don't know why Eddie Devine thought it was a good idea to start slapping Ken Keenan. He is literally about half the size of Keenan.
Size is everything, John.
All these men here are part of the tournament.
Well, this is the thing, they've been put totally on the spot here.
And the competition in that tournament is rife. All those men want that belt.
Eddie taking a pound in here.
That prestigious championship, which has been out of commission for such a long time, since being held captive by Gru.
Drew was a true champion, John. Let's not deny it.
Let's not talk about him. He's history.
Geography. But history has a habit of repeating itself. There's Spike Tierney.
Yes, Spike Tierney now. Spike Tierney, KJ Nitro now. Spike Tierney, taking no you know what from KJ Nitro.
What, shit. All set.
Yeah. Standing side headlock now by Spike. Nitro shoots one of the ropes. Shoulder block by Spike. Nitro didn't budge an inch. Another one. And the unstoppable force being the immovable object here. Oh, look at that! And another. What a Japanese arm drag as well by Spike. Beautiful standing moonsault. Only a two count.
Now here's the young John Kerr.
Here comes Kerr. And you know, I don't mind saying this, I've always said this. John Kerr was my favourite. Well, I say my favourite member of the GWO, that's like picking the best looking guy in jail. But John Kerr, I've always admired. He's such a young man with a heck of a lot of potential.
Yeah.
And I think now that he's free from the GWO, I think he can blossom on his own. And might be, he might very well be a dark horse in this future division tournament.
Definitely. Let's go for Gunzor, he is a very young guy as well.
John Kerr, yes indeed, he is only 16 or 17 years old.
Wow, what a physique for a young man like that.
He's in this business for 2 years already.
Whoa! Oh!
Good grief!
Johnny Thunder taking a hell of a pound in there. Whoa!
My goodness. Beautiful cannonball. Look at the colour of Johnny Thunder's chest with those shots. It's like a jar of beetroot.
Beat up member of the Red Hand Gang.
Let's go, Johnny.
There's Darren Blair. He's taking a hell of a beat.
Whoa! Oh my God!
Jesus!
Anything Kerr can do, Blair can do better.
And John Kerr acknowledging that. The master showed him how to do it. Blair is right in the mood.
Johnny
right
Thunder.
He's doing the floss. I think he's regretted doing the floss there.
To be honest, at this moment, I don't think he remembers doing the floss.
Yeah.
Darren Blair just took his head off with that clothesline.
Yeah, you better believe it.
I tell you, Darren Blair is one tough, rugged son of a bitch. He's not someone you want to get on the wrong side of. Beautiful suplex. Blair invited Ken Caden into the ring.
Seems to be about bad blood there. John Kerr.
John Kerr, two hard shots right to the top of the head of Johnny Thunder, and in comes
that Eddie.
The mouthpiece of this team.
See, for you to say.
How many more chops to the chest could Johnny Thunder take? Eddie going for a suplex of his own now.
Wow, well done, Eddie! What did I tell you, John? Eddie Devine was a wild card. told you, didn't I?
Oh, oh wow! Drop kick. Beautiful standing drop kick by KJ Nitro, who, as you see, is really looking in great shape. Showing off his athletic ability there.
That man is very angry.
Look at this now. Kerr had Johnny Thunder hoisted up on his shoulders. Oh, attack! In comes Spike Tierney. Spike now going to work on Kerr into the corner. Tag, in comes Ken Caden out for the first time in this match. Oh! Caden out kicking the legs away from Kerr. Oh! Beautiful drop kick. Only a two count. Caden hooking the leg.
John, see the monitors, could you get Cornish Street on this?
What?
On the monitors, could you get Cornish Street? Every time Caden's in the ring out there. I'm waiting on him doing something interesting, so I would like, when Ken Kane's in the ring, I would like to watch Gordon Easter Street, but that would be too much to ask.
Yeah, we should maybe talk to Braveheart about that one. Well, maybe we can hook you up for next show.
Yeah.
Nitro for the cover, two count only.
Something interesting is happening. Darren Blair's in the ring.
Oh! I don't know if you
Spike
can tell.
Tierney turned him up there.
I don't think so. I don't know if you can tell from your vantage point there, but both of the knees of Darren Blair are heavily braced. Those braces have got metal inside them. And the impact of that knee to the face. Plus metal. Ouch.
Well, the guy obviously needs him. He's had a lot of
work
on the
streets. Oh! God! Ken Caden hitting almost a GTS. Both men are down. Tags, in comes John Kerr, here comes Spike Tierney.
Whoa! Oh, holy.
Spike Tierney, a house of fire here.
Oh,
Spike now, top rope. Beautiful! Only a two count though. Great elevation on that cross body, however. Spike now. Oh, look at this! Look at this! Oh, he got him! He got him!
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winners!
There's a big melee in here.
We've got an absolute melee here. All eight men are all over the ring on Spike. Absolute carnage here in the Adler Complex. We've got a fist fight involving six men right in front of us here. Darren Blair and Spike are in the ring. Look at this now. Spike going for...
Oh, well done. What a move from Darren Blair. That was genius. Darren single-handedly took out seven wrestlers. Unbelievable.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, Kane Kane, Zach Heron, Johnny Thunder, and Spy Tears!
Well, that's a massive victory, a massive feather in the cap for Spike Tierney to get a victory over Darren Blair.
Look at Darren Blair's face, he's absolutely devastated.
As if Darren Blair couldn't be any more pissed off.
He is one angry, angry man. Somewhere soon, John. Some guy is going to take one hell of a beat. Lucky, Darren. Lucky, son.
Yes, sir. Very closely. 28th of December. Darren Blair. The Chelsea. The Queen's Hotel.